You got the control, Johnny?
Yeah, I have the control.
Put that on the Rose Bowl parade. There you
go. Rose Bowl parade.
And which island is that?
In the south of New York is Italy. And between the forests, Genoa, and different areas, we'll see all five towns, starting in Bernazza. Then we hike to Cornelia, on our...
I didn't see.
Is that Minaj?
No.
Nicki.
I think they say like Fits in the Tantrums and Rose Parade Youth Dancers.
Talking about that black woman.
I don't know who that is.
What? What is that? The girlfriend?
Let yourself free.
What? Yourself? My goodness. Okay. Look, Daddy, what is that, John?
That's the B-1 Lancer.
B-1's for flyover.
That's the one that's scared. It was at Macklin. They can't cruise in over. There's two of them.
Yep.
Cruising over there. Wasn't making no noise. Circle back around and came back and got about halfway to the runway. Hit the afterburner, and it went boom! And you would say, Daddy, mama. You wasn't the only one doing that now. Some grown folks was ducking too, because I was too. Scared me.
I was trying to get the mama. By the time I got to him, he was out of sight. We'll stay there.
And the horses have Instagram accounts, but parades are always timeless and a lot of fun.
That's so true.
gardens are timeless. We are talking about zillions of flowers, which we are seeing, because every single float here must be decorated exclusively with flowers and other organic materials, seeds and so forth, composting toilets. So welcome to the world's biggest garden on wheels. This year's theme is turning the corner, because it is a brand new year, and it's time for new beginnings. And
here is our
host of the parade.
Don't look at me, Mama.
I know, I'm liking this, so there's no turning back now. Buckle up, America. It's showtime.
It sure is. How about those bombers? It got me jumping around in my pearls a little bit.
Turned out to be a beautiful day here in Pasadena.
So lucky.
Sunny, and of course, it's on a Monday back in 1892. Fun fact for you. The organizers decided to move the parade whenever it falls on a Sunday because they didn't want it interfering with church services.
Yeah.
And they didn't want to scare the horses that are inside the churches.
Also a good idea, although maybe the bombers did scare them a little bit.
Yeah, exactly.
They had a lot of composure.
Come a long way from right now.
Yeah, they sure have.
So we're getting ready to see a lot of floats and beautiful wind. So here we go.
Here we go.
Our friends over at Honda are getting this party started with the first float of the day in celebration of Honda's
determination
to advance the future of mobility. Honda's brilliant engineers are working hard to meet some progressive goals.
Honda, wouldn't it? Honda Motor Company?
100% electric vehicle sales by 2040.
I don't know if they're getting cars in town.
I can't wait to see that, but then I guess the idea of advanced mobility will be tying my own shoes. I still do that.
But check out these amazing machines. They look like science fiction, but they're real. We got Honda's first electric SUV, Acura's electrified race car, which is head of a competition at Daytona, by the way, and an electric motorcycle, a Honda Jet, and a future mobility initiative.
That crowd is just loud as a parade for me. Why do you say that?
Yeah, man, his head hanging down over the thing.
This is called a corn husk on the underside of the mushroom caps create a ruffled yield effect, which is super interesting. Those are corn husks, not just flowers. And it won our extraordinaire trophy. Yeah, look at those purple carnations. They're incredibly excited about using them, but deep purple carnations.
That was a good idea. The fruit is giant snail on it.
Here's another impressive student group.
Woo-wee! Look at that man. Let's go. I'm going to have to give me a horn.
Let me see who it is.
Brookwood High School. Oh, I was going to add that to see if it was on channel 3. He's just dealing in his mouth.
That is 3.
Mm-hmm. And 5 got what?
The price is right.
Mm-hmm. How about 10? Don't you? What?
We did
feel it. Here's
the phone, Sarah. That's one of our favorites that we saw.
You see up close like that, the Spanish moss, feathers of seaweed, skeleton weed.
Mm-hmm.
They're so creative.
Shut up.
Turning that corner, which is so tough, that angle from Orange Grove to Colorado Boulevard, very impressively. And this really Well, this illustrates really the breadth of imagination here. This is Stupid Bunny Studios in partnership with Nouns. You can tell this is unlike most of the other floats, which are much like the one you just saw, filled with these beautiful shapes and curved shapes and elaborate detail. This is actually designed, as you can tell, to look pixelated, as befits the computer-generated NFTs that are depicted here. This actually comes from an artist.
Yeah.
Company, and they create these NFTs called
I couldn't read it and see if it's something.
Representative of some of the different nouns. There's shark. There's pickle on a surfboard, which is my favorite. And who doesn't love a pickle on a surfboard?
Naturally.
Tony Hawk actually helped with that design. And cone. And they're wearing these cool little glasses called goggles. And, you know, they actually do a lot of good, because once these are released and once they're sold, the funds are used for to support other artists. And they decided to use some funds to be here at the parade. Next up, we are honored to introduce and say hello to Gabby Gifford. She is the Grand Marshal for the 2023 Rose Parade, and she has turned many a corner during her career as a former member of Congress from Arizona. She's now a fierce advocate for gun control. As you may know, January 8, 2011, she was shot in the head by a gunman who killed 6 people, injured 12. She's able to return to the House of Representatives later that year, but she submitted her resignation in January of 2012. Yeah, and she received the Presidential Medal of Freedom last year to the U.S. Navy vessel named after. You can see her there with her husband, Mark Kelly, current U.S. Senator from Arizona and a former astronaut. We had the opportunity to hear her speak.
The astronaut brother,
here in town. Just so inspiring. And she talked about how she, after she was shot, had to learn how to walk again. She
never won married to that.
Everything's
been done.
She's a pump appreciator.
Never won married to you. Used to be a senator.
Like, literally being able to ride a
bike. Yeah, Gabby Gifford.
We can have her rock. So the Rose Bowl banquet. She'll be doing the coin toss today, too, at the game, right? Rose Bowl game coming up. How about her enthusiasm as well? And this. Just a beautiful segue, because this marching band, the Foothills Mountain Band, is from Gabby Gifford's hometown of Tucson, Arizona.
And that Foothills High School band,
the largest band in the state of Arizona,
258 members.
Which is the 64th largest in the state.
We hardly had that many students in the whole school.
He's doing that rope stuff. Trombone.
Giant toucans, baby ocelots, which kind of looks
looks like leopards, in a misty tropical jungle, all rendered in meticulous detail. I mean, we were again up close and personal with this float.
Oh, that's one of our favorites.
Awe, and the eyes, right? They're so beautiful. A highly floral float. And take a look at the baby ocelot. This is the close-up. The fur, pampas grass, oats, flaxseed, sounds like a smoothie along the way here, rice, coconut, straw flour, maybe not with the onion seed included in, or not the smoothies that I like, but again, more than 30,000 flowers on this beautiful float, which did win the judges award for the most outstanding design, and we like the drama, the dramatic impact. There's the eyes that we talked about.
Usually the little whites of the eyes are linaria petals, and it's just the detail and the imagination that it takes to pull these floats off, and that is incredible.
Definitely
worthy of an award for sure. And coming up, so much more on this day. This is a look at the Trader Joe's float. In progress, about 48 hours before the parade, and you can see all of that hard work. Over 900 volunteers here, and working up until the very last minute to bring you the 2023 Rose Parade.
Switch from TurboTax to H&R Block Online. Wow. The tax season will feel just as good as all those other seasons, like award season.
So you're doing your taxes yourself this season? I want to thank my dependents and my husband, Tom. You've always believed that I could switch to a better online tax service. And I did.
Upload last year's TurboTax return to switch to H&R Block.
Yeah.
If you struggle with CPAP, you should check out Inspire. Inspire, sleep apnea innovation. Learn more and view important safety information at inspiresleep.com.
Young lady who is mid-30s, couple of kids, recently went through a divorce. She had a lot of questions when she came in. I watched my mother go through being a single mom. At the end of the day, my mom raised three children, including myself. And so once the client knew that she was hurt, we were able to help her move forward. Your client won't care how much you know until they know how much you care.
Everybody down! Thank Robert!
Starting January 3rd, the rules will lose distance days, and they're teaming up with the feds for an action-packed crossover event.
A high school battle with a list of our agents currently in the field. This is...
Medicine.